Hello everyone, welcome to today's session. Today we will see how to build a itinerary process with dynamic resolver. We will try to resolve a itinerary process based on the message type that we receive on the on-ramp side. Once we enter the itinerary process, we would execute a map based on the message type we received using a BRE resolver. Then we will try to route the message to a destination system with the help of BRE resolver on the transformed message. In our previous session, we seen how to use itinerary with the static resolver. Today I will show a demo how to build a itinerary using a dynamic resolver. You would be receiving ESB message A or ESB message B on an on-ramp, and based on the message type we would execute the respective transformation, message A to message out or message B to message out. So we will try to select the itinerary dynamically and then execute the map dynamically, and then we will set the endpoint configurations dynamically. All these resolver we will try to resolve dynamically by using BRE resolver. Let me add a new ESB itinerary designer and name it as ESP.dynamic resolver. We would have an on-ramp, then we will have an itinerary service acting as a message extender, where we will be having a BRE resolver to do the transformation based on the message type we receive. So on-ramp extender will be selected on the on-ramp. Then we will specify the application name, ESPTJ, and I have created a receive port, one way receive port. So here is the receive port and the receive location. So I would be using a custom WCF custom adapter with web HTTP binding. So if I go to the browser and browse for the URL, as I have enabled the receive location, it should be browsable. So we will use a fiddler to push a message, and based on the message type it would transform the message and then route it to a destination system. I would add a BRE resolver. So let us go ahead and create a resolver for resolving the itinerary and then resolving the map and then resolving the endpoints. So let's create 3 BREs. Let me open the Business Rule Composer. I have created a policy bizdocdj.esb.itinerary-select and created a simple rule. So I will use the OR condition. If my message is of type A or type B, I should be executing the dynamic resolver iterative process. So in the fact explorer, I have taken the message schemas, message A and message B schemas. So on the fact explorer, I will choose both message A and message B schemas. And on the properties of each schema, you can find document type. I would change the document type to Microsoft.practices.esb.resolve-provider-message. So I will do it for both message A and message B. Now let me drag the root node, and you can find it automatically got changed to, if the root node exists in the Microsoft practice.esb.resolve-provider-message. So I will add one more condition for the message B type. There are predefined vocabularies for setting the ESB related data. So to set the ESB itinerary, we have a vocabulary ESB.itinerary, and I will set the itinerary name as ESB.dynamic-resolver. So let me publish and deploy the rule. And similarly, I have created a simple map resolver policy. So I will configure the rule. If it is of message A, I would set the transform type with the fully qualified name of message A to message out transformation. So simple way to take the fully qualified name is like create a static itinerary and then select the fully qualified map name. So this is the fully qualified map name for message A to message out. And similarly, I would do it for message B. You can implement the halt if required on each rules. So similarly, I have created a policy to set the endpoint information, routing information. So as we are using a transformation at the receive side, the message would be transformed to the out message. So this BRE has to execute on the out message. So I will browse and choose the ESB out message schema, and similar to the earlier changes that we did on message A and message B, we will do it on the message out also. You change the document type to resolve provider message. So based on the requester node on the out message, if it is A, we will route the message to a out directory, A out directory, and we will use a file adapter. Similarly, If it is B, we will route the message to a different directory.
Now let us deploy these three rules and restart the rule engine.
Coming back to the itinerary project, we would specify the BRE policy name to execute the dynamic map. So we will use one more itinerary service and then we will select it as an off-ramp extender where we will be specifying the endpoint configuration through a BRE resolver, and we will use the BRE policy that we created, stockdj.esb.routinginfo. Let's connect the messaging extender with the off-ramp extender, then we will have the off-ramp. Now we will create a Dynamics endpoint and we will associate the off-ramp with the Dynamics endpoint and connect the off-ramp extender and off-ramp. Let us create a dynamic one-way port and name it as pstockdj.dynamicresolver.oneway, and I would specify the service name, service state and service type. So here is the filter conditions. Service name is set as DJ Dynamic Resolver, service state is pending and service type is message. So back to the itinerary, we would configure the off ramp with the send port. We would specify the Bistock application name and choose the send port. Now let us connect the off-ramp extender and off-ramp. And we will associate the off-ramp extender with the off-ramp. Now let's validate and let us go to the ESB itinerary property and we will rename the name it as ESB.dynamicresolver. Let us change the model exporter to database and export it again. Exported successfully.
Let us go to the admin console and specify the connection string for resolving the itinerary process dynamically.
Now let us place some request message. So we would be placing a ESB message B and then message A. So here is the sample request that we would be using it. So let me go to the configured out directory. So message A would be transformed to outbound message and would be available in the A directory, and B would be available in the B directory as a transformed message. So using Fiddler, you would be pushing the message to the on-ramp service. So here is our URL, localhost/dynamic-resolver. And let us post a message A and we would see the directories. So both the messages got successfully processed. Now let us go to the out folder and validate the message that we got on the So for the message type A, we got a ESP message out on the A directory, and here you can see the requester is A. Similarly, we can see a message for the requester B on the B directory. Let us process one more message. And we would see the results again. I have processed a message and I have now processed a B message. Let us go to the out directory, and here you can see the file being prefixed with B or A based on the requester type. Today we have seen how to build a itinerary process and where we can use BRE resolver to dynamically resolve the map, routing information, or even an itinerary service. Thanks for watching the video.